That isn't what he was saying. If a person says, you know, I don't like burning the flag, that's not the same position as people who burn the flag should be deported. That's not the same position. Did I see the Hunter Avallone versus Redacted debate? No, I didn't. What were they even debating over?
Were you? Is it true that you used to be a former Republican?
Dude, this was before I was any kind of public figure.
So what? Is it true that you used to be a registered Republican?
Absolutely.
People can change. Are you serious?
What? I believe in changing.
Interesting. Wait, you switched to being a Democrat just so you could run against the candidate that already BTFO'd your mom in the same race? Oof. That sounds really griftery, dude. Apparently, you raised over 50K? Shit.
First of all, I raised over 100K.
Holy fuck. This guy raised over 100K by just switching to being a Democrat. Sounds like something a grifter would
do.
So I didn't know this, but apparently Mike was a Republican and Mike's mom was a Republican. And then Mike switched to Democrat and then ran against the candidate that beat his mom. So he'd have an easier win in the election than he lost. I had no idea. That's crazy. I think that was just a your mom joke. Wait, is that true? Is that not true? It is true? Yeah, wait, I heard that was Mike from PA used to be a regular right-wing caller on the David Pakman show. One of the people who do the purity testing the hardest are the ones who have the most to hide. Like Mel on Twitter, who said that, like, she'll never trust former Nazis or whatever. But then, like, there's a post from 6 months ago of Mel saying that she used to be, like alt-right adjacent, like 4chan Pepe posting, like, reactionary. Like, the people who gatekeep the hardest are the people who are the most dishonest about their own past, you know? They're not the purest people, okay? The funny thing is that I wasn't really like a right winger at any point. I was like kind of an edgy libertarian when I was 15, but I wasn't like anti-gay or trans. I was more like gay people are cool, but like pride parades can get kind of preachy. That was the worst I got. And then from there, it was just more and more left-leaning, you know? It's funny because like my movement on the like political compass squares was like, I started like lib center. And then I just kept moving left. But like other people who've spent their whole lives bouncing like a fucking pong game accuse me of yeah, you know? All right, I want to see a couple minutes of this. Do you think we can handle that just really quick?
Hello, Mike from PA. You know how long I wanted to ask you what a TIFF is? And now I'm finally here able to talk to you and ask you to your face.
I think you're going to go with Vaush community memes. You really want to know? I mean,
wait. You tell. Wait. I still don't know what a TIFF. I'm never gonna know. Even if he tells me, the info is gonna leave my brain right after.
No, I'm not. No. I'm not gonna go with. No, I'm not gonna go with Vaush community memes. I'm more interested in what.
By the way,
I'm more interested if you did any research at all before making that little stream segment on me, because it was some of the most poorly researched content I think I'd ever seen.
It's almost like the video you made against me, Hunter.
Some of what you said was just so entirely factually incorrect.
Factually incorrect.
Yeah, so for example, what do you think my... Wait. What do you think my speech at Penn State was about?
Before we begin, you start yelling about whatever slight you feel that you've been slighted. Could you, for the audience, explain kind of what you think your politics is today?
Man, why does Mike do this? Why does he do this, like, placating alpha male, like, talk you down thing? He can't pull it off. He doesn't... The problem is that rhetorical approach only works if you come off as, like, naturally confident. But he doesn't. He comes off as, like, very insecure and overcompensating. So it doesn't... If he was, like a lantern-jawed, like, alpha male Chad who, like, just slays on the reg, and he's like, yeah, dude, so wait, hold on, real quick, just calm down, bro. So, like, what did you mean earlier? Like, can you explain this to me? Like, that, like, okay, fine, you know, but it's, I don't know. So it's in the beginning? Hold on.
Got into a pledge focused on justice when Vaush raised a bunch of money to help Palestinian children. How does that make me a rat if you thought it was a bad
professional grifter, Hunter Avallone? Okay, wait, here we go. Okay, so Mike has his own video on it. Because I wanted it without like any commentary. I don't want a double commentary. I like how when you look up Mike from PA, the first thing that shows up. Okay, wait. It's the video that's playing now. The second thing that shows up is him talking to me. And then, oh no. There we go. There's his channel. All right. Professional grifter Hunter Avallone. Let's mold in the
central committee. A little topic that I saw pop up on my
it's 25 minutes
on my timeline right when I was that I had to reply. Oh no, he deleted it. What a little rat. Oh, he deleted it. Oh no. I'm glad he listened to me. I'm glad he listened to me and shut the fuck up. But we're still going to call him out. We're not going to. He gained prominence as one of the biggest gamer gators on YouTube. Oh, this is a couple years ago, right?
It was this item. Shu, if you don't know the lore about Mike from PA, you are missing out, okay? This guy is one of the biggest lol cows on like the lefty Twitch, maybe the biggest. This is some rich lore, okay?
Penn State chapter of Turning Point U.S. position is cringe! I mean, he started when he was literally a teenager. He started making his videos literally as a teenager. That's why Hunter Avallone did so well, because he was in the teenager brain space of like, if you disagree with me, I will just call you cringe.
That's kind of true. I mean, I'm not exactly a fan of Hunter Avallone's old content. I think that's fair criticism. Let's just watch.
Mike from PA is getting on. Yeah. Not the
slight you feel that you've been slighted. Could you, for the audience, explain kind of what you think your politics is today?
I consider myself kind of a social democrat.
So when you say social democrat, do you mean the traditional definition of it that you'll find on Wikipedia, which is a socialist who believes in a democratic transition?
No.
I'm sorry. Let me just go on Wikipedia right now. Let me just really quickly... Described by academics as advocating economic and social interventions to promote social justice within the framework of a liberal democratic polity and a capitalist-oriented mixed economy. It says that it's a political, social, and economic philosophy within socialism. Does it say that this is like a democratic process for transitioning into socialism? Due to longstanding governance by social democratic parties, influence, social democracy, Keynesianism, Nordic model, social liberal paradigm, welfare states. Social democracy originated as a political ideology that advocated an evolutionary and peaceful transition from capitalism to socialism, using established political processes in contrast to the revolutionary approach to transition associated with orthodox Marxism. So it says that was the original... That was the original line. But then in the early post-war era of Western Europe, social democratic parties rejected the Stalinist political and economic model in the Soviet Union, committing themselves to an alternate path to socialism or to a compromise between socialism and capitalism. So the only thing that it really says is that the origin of this term was meant to be the reformist wing of socialism, which is true. But since then, it's come to describe more broadly, like, you know, well, what we typically call social democracy. I don't know.
When I say social democrat, I mean like I want like stronger social safety nets, but I think we can still work
so
within our current
like
system.
You mean more like a social liberal or like a liberal?
Maybe more of a liberal, yeah.
Again, keep in mind that what Hunter's describing here is social democracy within the Wikipedia definition.
I guess I would consider myself more of a social democrat or... I
now,
guess
would you
centrist
say
liberal.
You're fixed? Would
but
you
I'm
say
not,
you're
hold on, I'm not interested in talking
yourself.
About my positions here, because...
Wait, what do you mean? This is what this is about.
No, it's
you're
not.
Saying that
it's about
changed.
The fact that
wait,
you
wait,
made
wait,
a segment on me.
Wait, you're saying you've changed and you should get a benefit of the doubt.
Wait, there we go again. You're lying you already. When did I say I should have a benefit of the doubt? This is what I mean, is why you don't know about
so
me.
What you're
you, I don't
is
think
you
understand who I am.
He's never said that. Of all the people I've seen who have moved left... Hunter Avallone has complained the least about the treatment and reception that he's gotten from the left. There are some people I know who, after more visibly moving left, have constantly grinded against and argued with other left-leaning people. But Hunter Avallone has been, I think, incredibly dignified in the progression of his, you know, beliefs.
That's why I'm asking you right now. I'm trying to clear it up for misapprehension of the audience. I think a lot of your audience thinks of you as someone who was on the alt-right and who transitioned to...
Alt-right.
We don't really know yet, because you're, again, when alt-right. I asked you what you were, you changed already in this conversation from a social democrat, now you're a social liberal.
No, stop.
Oh my god.
No.
Dude, this is the weakest attempt at pushing for hypocrisy I've ever seen. Dude, you're already backpedaling, bro. You said you were a social democrat, now you're saying you're a social liberal, and like... No. He said he's a social democrat, and he's a social democrat.
You're already being super bad faith, and I don't appreciate this, okay? So we're going to go through the claims you made directly about me.
All I asked you was what your positions are.
By the standards of the way that we define what a social democrat is, I would definitely fall under that definition. That's why I tell people in a general, in an American sense, I am a social democrat. On an online sense, I would be more of a centrist. That's what I've said, and I've said that consistently. But we're not here to talk about that right now. We're first going to talk about your segment. We're going to go through it a little bit and talk about some of these things. The first thing being, you've said multiple times that my...
Now, this is the strong controlling hand of an alpha male with a trad wife, okay? This is Hunter. He's raising kids right now. This is him laying down the spank, okay? And he is a father, all right? Has developed.
Speech at Penn State was on transgender people attacking transgender individuals.
That's not what I said. I said you
didn't say that.
If you can read what I said in the tweet, and I'll read it out loud for everybody, is that you were with Turning Points USA. You were going to Turning Points USA stuff as recently as 2019.
What do you think my speech was about then?
And you guys were discussing deplatforming, and they had a conspiracy theory about deplatforming, and you said, well, I don't think that the right is unfairly targeted. Which, to give you
credit, did you know that when you made the segment?
But that's...
I think I have to DM Hunter and ask him to turn down the volume on his alerts.
Did you know that when you made the segment on me, though?
It doesn't change significantly anything I'm saying.
Yes, it does. No, I'm not, because you're being so dishonest right now.
Because you were with Turning Points USA, you were allied with the far right as recently as 2019, and you were making anti-left-wing videos. I went and looked at your catalog, because I've been told you've changed. And within the last year, you have a whole catalog of anti-leftist, anti-feminist, all sorts of, you know,
first of all,
Gamergate-esque content, you know, attacking people for, you know, basically.
Okay, so right here, buddy, on Twitter, you say this snake was literally...
Let me finish. I'm going to keep talking when you're not.
Can I read my tweet?
So you do the Kiwi Farms lol cow shit. You have your top videos are all attacking people like AOC,
which, by the way, weren't monetized. So there's that.
They were limited monetization. We just saw it earlier in your show that they were in fact monetized, but Google and YouTube.
No, I demonetized those videos. I turned off the monetization.
On the other videos that we could see right on this, we could go back to the VOD and we can.
So it's funny that like Mike would try to desperately impugn Hunter for backpedaling when Mike is now saying that he never claimed that Hunter Avallone was attacking trans people during that TPUSA event. And here's the tweet. This snake was literally at TPUSA events in the end of 2019 attacking trans people. Like, it's right here. It's right here. He just said he didn't say what the content of this tweet is, you know?
Look and see that they were limited monetization.
We're already getting so off
subject. When you discuss politics on YouTube, they often demonetize that because a lot of
you're literally saying things back to me that I just said in this segment. It's obvious that you sat here and watched it and then refined what you were going to say. So let me ask you this.
No, you made it.
Is this tweet yours? Did you say this? This snake was literally at a... Okay.
You're actually confronting what I'm actually saying. I'm having trouble dealing with what I'm actually saying, which is you have put out and continue to have harmful content. Maybe you should talk to some of
like
your new
what?
Friends
like what?
About the anti-feminist stuff. And you saying that you are the No, see, you're not attacking feminists. See, you're doing a advanced critique, offsetting liberal feminism from true socialist feminism, but you're not a socialist. So why
no,
are
I'm
you
saying there's a difference between real feminist efforts versus pop feminism? But we've already
can somebody explain to me what Mike from PA's argument even is? I'm genuinely asking right now. Like, what is the actual argument that is being made here? Like, is he just mad that Hunter Avallone is on good terms with myself and Destiny? Is that it? Is that literally it? Is that the only thing?
Already moved off because you've denied making this claim and you have lied about it, and then you're not letting me actually read your tweet.
I didn't lie anything. Go ahead.
You said that
you have reading comprehension.
This snake was literally at Turning Point USA events at the end of 2019 attacking transgender people.
Yeah.
So yeah. Do you know what my speech at Penn State was about?
Were you attacking transgender people in 2019? Yes.
No.
No. Listen to this snake, dude. He's spineless. This tweet right here at TPUSA events, the end of 2019, attacking trans people. I didn't do that. Okay. Well, were you attacking trans people at all in 2019? He doesn't believe anything that he says.
Are you sure about that?
Yes. Okay. If I'm not mistaken, I'd already taken down my truth about transgenders video. And that's why when you tried to search for it on your live stream, because I saw the VOD, you couldn't find it because it's been taken down. And if you had actually gone on my channel.
Yeah, but okay. But
hold
when
on.
Was it posted? When was the truth about transgenders
in
original
2016?
Posting?
At the very beginning of 2016.
Okay. I'm sorry. That's okay. That's right. You were attacking transgender people. You were being brought in to. Okay. So your gotcha is you were not
what point
that
is he
video
trying
was
to
old,
make?
And you made a new video recently about the truth of transgenders.
I've made another video 11 months ago called The Truth About Transgenders.
11 months ago.
Debunking.
So
hold
it?
On, wait, you're not
year?
Letting me finish.
What year was that? What year was that?
Mike, yeah. This video was debunking my notorious transgender video, okay? I'm going through explaining why the original video was
so
wrong.
So when would you say you transitioned from being alt-right? Or
no, see, no, by the way, I don't think that Hunter was ever all right, but notice that Mike, like, he'll just say something. When it's wrong, he'll just move to the next thing. He's wrong, he'll just move to the next thing. Nothing, like, just jumps to the next thing. Absolutely no acknowledgement, no recognition. And he knows he's doing it too. This is why he's such a pathetic, greasy, slimy little fuck. It's because he knows it. There is a physical cost to being this slippery, okay? It's like succumbing to the warp in 40K, all right? He's calling upon psyker powers, all right? It's corrupting him, all right? His body is wilting every time he does this.
I mean, I was even defending, like, trans people. Now, granted, probably not as well as I could have been, but I was even defending transgender people back in, like, the end of... When was the Jessica Yaniv thing? Because I'm going through my channel to try to
find like,
out.
Okay, but so I think your point about that, so you really want to have a debate with me over the exact month where you made a specific, about
no.
No, that's what you're debating him on. Mike's like, this video shows you didn't like trans people as recently as a year ago. And he's like, oh, no, that video is actually me critiquing my old self. Mike's like, this is really what you want to do? You want to debate me on the exact date that you like? Dude, Mike, come on, man.
That's the opposite of it. It's just that you're lying about me, right? So that's the first thing that I wanted to clear up, is that you're saying that I'm at Penn State attacking transgender people, but that's not true.
But you were invited to Penn State by Turning Points because you were a famous alt-right YouTuber, right?
Well, okay, wait, hold on. Just to be really clear, alt-right means neo-Nazi, okay? The term alt-right was a coded PC term for neo-Nazi. The alt-right, like, people online, has a meaning, okay? Now, unless there was some phase to Hunter Avallone I'm not familiar with, the most he was a Christian conservative. He was, like, trad-conny, okay? I don't think that Hunter Avallone ever, ever, ever had, like, race realist content on his channel. I don't think he was ever calling for the destruction of democracy. I don't think he ever dog whistled about the Jews. Like, yeah, I don't think there's I don't think he was ever alt-right, like, at all. He was, like, trad-con Christian conservative type. Like these words mean things.
That's wrong. No, I was invited to TPUSA for a censorship event where I then talked about how conservative censorship isn't happening, which led to my massive fallout with the alt-right and got
huge Chad move, by the way. Hunter Avallone got invited to this conference to talk about how conservatives are being censored, and they went up there and said they aren't. Huge Chad move. He got in a fuck ton of social media trouble after this. Holy shit. Giga Chad move. Okay?
Got me so attacked by people like Mark Dice.
Why did Turning Points USA invite you?
Because they didn't know that. Because I hadn't actually...
Oh, they didn't know. So you were invited because you were an alt-writer.
Wait. I was still labeled myself a conservative at that time. Yeah, that's everyone okay. knew that. I hadn't actually made
and
my formal announcement about
yourself?
Leaving the right.
Now,
but I was...
This
hold on, but I was...
Know this, but I want, for my fans and other people that watch this, when did you stop labeling yourself conservative publicly?
If
you
in the beginning of 2020. I think it was in March.
So...
That was publicly,
my,
but I was already
my,
fighting
the
with the right
actually,
a ton throughout okay. 2019.
So your problem is that you weren't actually attacking transgender people at that event.
What he can't, Mike keeps calling Hunter out on something being wrong and then going, huh? So your argument is that this didn't happen. Okay. But then you were a conservative before, or it's like he can't, he's shadow boxing himself and losing. Yeah, Mike is going to punch so many couches after this. Mike is doing the rhetorical equivalent of punching the little, like, boxing speed bags and getting hit with the fucking recoil every time, you know, on the blowback.
But you were attacking transgender people up until basically 2020.
No,
just that specific
false
event,
again. Okay.
Okay,
I stopped my, listen, my stances and opinions on trans people started changing more and more behind the scenes, and that's reflective in my content. You can go
so
back
you
to
want credit for something you didn't.
I'm not
do
asking
publicly.
For credit.
Oh my
See
god!
How you keep pivoting to that? I'm not asking for credit here. I'm just explaining.
Well, you're saying that I lied about you when I'm my
yes because
you
said
public conservative.
You said I was at a Turning Point USA okay. event at the end of 2019 attacking transgender people. Your claim there.
You went to this TPUSA event to attack trans people. And then, no, I didn't. Oh, so you want credit for not attacking trans people at that TPUSA event? How low the bar has been set, Hunter. My God. I have vouched for this. I talked to him in person in 2018. He talked about his opinions changing. Yeah, reminder, by the way, the only reason that I ever tried to talk to Hunter Avallone the way that I did was because I talked to Shoe on Head beforehand. I thought that Hunter Avallone was just another, like, dumb fuck, no principles conservative. Shoe on Head messaged me and said, like, hey, I've, like, met Hunter Avallone before. I think that he's, like, an authentic guy. Like, I think he actually cares about the stuff that he believes in. And that's the only reason everything following with me and Hunter Avallone happened. My, like, willingness to talk with him, the friendliness afterwards, like, all that. He probably still would have moved over to the left of his own volition. But, like, that process, at least from my end... was facilitated by Hunter Avallone and not Hunter, Shoe on Head encouraging me to treat Hunter Avallone like better or like, I guess with like more consideration for his good faith than would otherwise happen. So yeah. A lot of stuff out there. You hold on, Somnio. The thing's actually tomorrow. The appointment. I was wrong about the date. Thanks for the $50, loser. Hey.
There is that at the end of 2019, so very recently, Hunter was attacking trans people. That is your claim, and your claim is wrong. And I think
when
that you should
you
concede that.
When did you stop attacking trans people? When did you? I mean, I can. Gosh, I guess I can go through your fucking entire YouTube catalog.
Why don't you just concede that you were wrong here in this claim, and we can move on to the next part of the conversation.
The claim was you were literally at a Turning Point USA events at the end of 2019.
Attacking trans people.
That's right.
And I didn't attack trans people at that event. The opposite. At that point, by this time, just so you know, by this point, okay, I had made videos attacking anti-vaxxers. I had made videos defending trans people very largely. I had had
anti-vax? Is that a far right thing?
It's a far right thing. Yeah. And guess what? It lost me a lot of subscribers. I made a video attacking
people. What kind of gotcha is that from Mike? Yeah, being anti-vax tends to be associated with being the far right. What? Does he not know? Is he not aware of what's happening right now?
People that were race realists, I made a video going through debunking race realism bullshit, okay? A lot of the times... A lot of the times these videos were marketed in a way that did look offensive from the outside. If you see a video that says the truth about black people, of course that sounds fucking...
I have you here in November 4th, 2019 with transgender kids. It's time to stop. Prepare to be shocked. Today we examine the dangerous push by the left for transgender children to under...
Notice how none of this means anything? Mike already lost. At this event, the event that he said Hunter Avallone attacked trans people at, Hunter Avallone didn't attack trans people. It doesn't matter. None of this matters. It's meaningless.
Go early in irreversible transitioning.
I was talking about some niche. I was
in October 2020. Okay, so I have a video, a picture of you. The event was at October 23rd, 2019. On your YouTube right now, November 4th, 2019, transgender kids, it's time to stop. You were attacking transgender people.
No,
you
I wasn't. That's not true, actually. In that video, no.
Right now? I'm making a point. Stop talking. So you here are claiming that there's this big push by the left to do irreversible transitions of children.
That's actually wrong. In that video, I talk about puberty blockers. That's not true.
This is transphobic.
No, in that what I was doing, okay, as my channel, as my opinions were developing and changing, I was communicating that in my channel in a way that would be digestible to a more right-wing audience. If you watch that video, you'll see at the end, I actually talk about a good option for treatment oftentimes is puberty blockers. I was talking about these niche situations where there was like an, I think an actual like experiment done. I'm not sure. I would have to go back and look at the video, but either way, that was before I announced that I had formally left the right. And literally,
so you were pushing. So what I'm saying is,
no.
So the thrust of what I was saying. From my point of view, pushing a dangerous narrative that there's a bunch of leftists out there trying to forcibly transition children.
So this is I don't know if this is like a low IQ thing or whatever, but like this is pretty clearly Mike not understanding the very, very, very basic elements of how to move over a right-leaning audience. If you're just like, yeah, dude, I like trans people now, like, just drop that video, it's going to be kind of hard, you know? You're not going to move a lot of people over. But potentially, you have the ability to move far more people over if you're like, yeah, these people are crazy, but puberty blockers are an acceptable option. That's, like, pretty reasonable, I think? I don't know which video he's referring to here.
Is garbage.
That's not what I said. I don't. No, I don't believe that's what I said in that video.
The video is about trying to highlight this move by the left. You don't say a move by a few fringe people. You say a move by the left.
I still identified as a conservative then, dude. What do you not understand from that?
Why don't you understand that you were anti-trans when you were going to Turning Points USA events? Now, this is not me doing a purity test. This
Yes, first of all, yes, it is. But so that you've moved so far away from the initial claim you made, which was that I was at this event attacking trans people.
Hunter, the claim I made has been fully substantiated. I claim.
My original claim was that some point in the past you were conservative, and now I've proven that. Conversation over.
You were attacking trans people and you were going to Turning Points USA events.
Nope. He said attacking people, trans people at Turning Point USA events. The tweet is right there. Mike, why do you commit to positions like that? Like, Mike, I understand that you're really insecure and you think that your entire identity will crumble if you ever acknowledge that you've made a mistake. Why not just say, oh, I was wrong on this? However, you did have some problematic like elements to your content back then, right? And Hunter would go, yeah, I totally did. And then you could go, okay, like, why would you die on this hill? This is the worst hill. It's not even a hill. It's like a pothole. You're dying for a pothole, man.
Now, you're right. You didn't attack trans people at that event. But a week later, you went back home and you published a YouTube video spreading propaganda that's used against trans people.
First of all, I would have to go back to look through that video, okay? But I know for a fact that that was
before.
My dude.
That's what your legacy is.
That's not
even. Now, guess what?
That is what your legacy is. By the way, I'm not purity testing, but I believe in legacies now. If your legacy is conservative content, then you're never going to be a real leftist. Jesus.
Hold on.
Guess what?
Do I get a chance to talk? Do I get a chance to talk?
You haven't let me finish a sentence. Every time I make a sentence, you start talking in the middle. So the problem that we're having here is that I would like you to change. But the first step to rehabilitation and restorative justice is for you to admit that these were harmful.
The first step to restorative justice, Inquisitor Mike coming in to rehabilitate. By the way, Mike, This is the exact kind of phony moral puritanism that, like, everybody knows is motivated by a desire to virtue signal that pushes people away from the left. You might as well be like those 14-year-olds on Tumblr saying that, like, white people are inherently right-wing or something. This is so beyond fuck, dude. How can you possibly consider yourself an advocate for left? Like, oh yeah, dude, here I am. I'm holding you to account. How do you not crawl up into your own asshole out of cringe saying that? I'm holding you to account. How do you do that? Like, how does that not make you want to die? I want to know.
Full, these were dangerous, and they don't represent you anymore.
I would have to go back to look. Hold on.
Can somebody find that video for me? The video they keep talking about? The video about kids, whatever, that?
But the videos you don't agree with anymore, because that would be a substantial move.
So first of all,
that would be a substantial move for you.
Okay, can I respond now, please?
It would be a substantial move for Hunter Avallone to say that he disagrees with earlier content. That sure would be a new one for him.
Dude, Mike,
don't believe this anymore.
I know you just want to preach at me, but I also want to respond.
I'm not preaching. I'm giving you an example of restorative justice.
All right, go ahead. Give me the list. I'm going to write it down.
You don't. That would be.
Oh, man, we got documents.
Videos that publish ideas you don't agree with anymore.
Okay.
That would be the first step.
All right.
The second would be apologize for the bad videos you made, and third, stop making videos attacking feminists, attacking leftists that you don't know. You've never talked to, and. Then I won't have to go and point out that one of your top videos is calling AOC an idiot.
First of all, I'm not really worried about the AOC thing. I don't have to agree with your left stuff to be like considered rehabilitated. So we can move off the AOC thing.
So you think of AOC as an idiot? You think of
I would
AOC
have to again. These are older videos. I'd have to go back and look at. So let's actually go through this.
Because you want to keep that money rolling. You like that AOC hate money.
Oh my God, dude, Mike, Hunter Avallone sacrificed everything algorithmically. Like, how can anyone call Hunter a grifter? Seriously. You know why you're saying all this stuff? Because you just want the money to come rolling in. I can't, like, his video views, his subs, everything have gone down massively since he moved over to the left. This is what integrity looks like, okay? Other people may laugh at this shit, but this is a fucking badge of honor, okay? This means that Hunter Avallone's political positions are motivated by his real beliefs and not by a desire to grift. There is no greater guarantee that he's not a grifter. Nothing even comes close to this. Everyone on Earth is more of a grifter than Hunter Avallone, okay? You cannot make this accusation against him. Yeah, where's that clip of Mike from PA saying he doesn't want to cover, like, local politics because he would make less money doing it?
Please get involved in the process.
There we go.
Seems like that might be more fruitful than having another one of these discussions that does nothing.
Okay. The reason why people organize around presidential elections is because they get tens of billions of dollars of free media. It's a unifying election that everybody in the entire country knows about, and it gives us a common language that we can reach more and more people.
Why is he vibrating?
If you go into mutual aid stuff, that is inherently a very local action. If I go and do mutual aid shit, my audience will go from thousands of people to 50 people.
What?
Because they're going to all be in their own communities doing local actions and not doing anything that's oriented towards national politics.
What?
This is a defeating. And also, can we be real? Who's going to turn? Can you show me the mutual aid streamers? The people that just sit there discussing mutual aid all day?
What are you talking about? You can diversify your content. You can talk about more than just that. What?
Okay, guys.
I want to point out, by the way, what he's saying, there's a nugget of truth to it. I don't focus a lot on local politics because I know that a lot of people wouldn't really care about it. I like everybody being engaged with what I have to say. I like participating in the national conversation. But in the light of comments that Mike is making about Hunter, this comes off incredibly hypocritical. If you are going to call Hunter Avallone the least grifting human on Earth a grifter, then you get to be impugned for everything that you've said prior that can be interpreted as evidence of grifting, okay? Jesus, you know? But it's so easy to make local politics resonate nationally when it counts. Yeah, you got to find the right, like, it's like when the anvil is hot or whatever, you know? You got to find the right opportunity, the time to hit it appropriately. Like when we do our canvassing in the near future. You strike when the iron is hot. Yeah. I'm just saying, like, you can't make these comments. Yeah, I guess the anvil wouldn't need to be hot, actually. Anyway, the point that I'm getting at is that, like, you can't make comments like that and then call Hunter Avallone a grifter, okay?
Money. Okay. Yeah, I gotta keep that money.
Hey, Mike, can I talk now, please? Because you gave me a list, and I'd like to go through this. So the first thing, private the videos. If you'd like, we can pull up my social blade and look at how I have already privated a fuck ton of my videos. Mm-hmm. My most
still
popular...
more harmful shit. I was able to find one right here.
Wait. Can you wait, please? Some of these videos that I removed had over 3 million views, and I've purged my channel of over 20 million views. Now, some of these videos that are still up, that are kind of old, that I might not agree with, are not monetized. And some of these videos that you're pointing to, like the transgender children one, that wasn't that long ago, I would have to look over that video again.
This is such a damned if you do, damned if you don't situation, because if you do delete all of your old bad videos, people will accuse you of trying to run from your past. That happens all the time. Whenever, like, people who used to be more on the right start deleting or privating old videos, people will be like, oh, you're just trying to hide your past, you know? And, like, yeah. But then if you don't delete them, it's like, you're letting them continue to hurt. Probably, like, the best way to do it would be to unlist them and put them all in a playlist, like, named My Old Bad Takes or something. That way, they aren't capable of being found through the algorithm, but if people want to go back and, like, take a look at the old, like, cringe stuff, then they can. That's probably the best way to do it. This is still pretty, like, pretty damned if you do, damned if you don't, you know?
But either way, your assertion that I need to private videos, I have done, largely. Now, I don't know if you know this, and I'm not saying this to be demeaning, but if I were to just terminate or, like, nuke every video, that would essentially kill my channel even more than it's already been murdered because I moved away from the right.
So, okay, so your concern is your financial.
Jesus.
No,
the financial
wrong.
Ramifications.
No, it's that I cannot just nuke my entire channel. This has to be done in a process. Okay. And the next thing you said, apologize.
The transition to, like, making left wing content. You want to do it slowly.
No,
over
I'm
time.
Not. I'm not. Like, this is what you think that.
Dude, he already makes left wing content, though. Look at this. Sometimes he has titles that are meant to be, like, amicable to a right-wing audience, but, like, the actual content, look at this. Nationalism is cringe. Rainbow capitalism is good, actually. I know what you're thinking, but here he's just saying that it's actually a great thing that corporations are willing to pander to gay people, which I agree with. Making fun of the black conservative defending Derek Chauvin, criticizing people for being racist if they say China virus. Calling out white nationalists, tearing into Steven Crowder. Here is why I hate Pride Month. Now, something tells me this isn't actually going to be anti-Pride Month. We all do clickbait titles, including me. Anti-Charlie Kirk. Anti-critical race theory, it looks like. Pro-gay, making fun of Steven Crowder. Like, all of his stuff here... Disney's gay problem. You know what this video is? It's pointing out that Disney is inauthentic in their support of gay people. Like, making fun of PragerU. Hey, here's my face. Mike from PA is a disingenuous loser. And here's me. Look, I'm in the corner over there. See? That's me. Debating Lauren Southern. I remember that one. Hunter deserves way more views and subs. I hope that Hunter, like, gets... I hope that Hunter ends up getting a huge, like, rebound on his views and stuff, because I have never seen so much personal growth in one person's YouTube career. And I don't mean that, I don't mean that euphemistically or, like, hyperbolically. I mean that for real. I have never seen so much growth in one person's YouTube career. It's not just, like, moving to the left. It's this fundamental restructuring of everything about his old content. Here, if we go all the way back here, it's, you know, all the old stuff. And then, like, it's like a gradient, like, all the way up here. And now it's based shit. Look at that. Yeah, he's also a really nice guy. Like, not, like, really, like, just a good person, you know? Really good person.
That I'm here to, like, try to make this, like, left-wing content, when that's not my goal. My intention here is to just share the way that my opinion has shifted, okay? And a lot of my old videos that I had views that I no longer agreed with, I have privated and deleted them. And not only that, not only have I privated these videos, I have lost subscribers a fuck ton, by the way, nearly 80,000. I've lost money, okay? And I've made videos where I debunk these old videos. Videos where I talked about liking Donald Trump, I've debunked that one. Videos where I criticized trans people, I've debunked that one. Videos where I said that that gay people were weird or whatever, I debunked that one. I went through and I have debunked this shit, okay? So not only have I privated these videos, and not only have I quote-unquote apologized for the videos, I have offered substantial responses and breakdowns of why those videos were wrong and why my opinions have shifted. So, two notes on your list, I feel I have accurately met those goals. Privating the videos, I'm still in the process of privating more. Like I said, it has to be done in a process, but if you want, we can pull up my social blade and see how many views I lost. Would you like to look at it?
I mean, we can look at your social
blade. Mike, by the way, Mike is about to say either, he's going to say two things. He's going to say, nice, but this isn't enough. And then he's also going to say, wow, are you trying to like win points for all this? You grifter. He's going to say both of those things.
Social blade, if that is something you feel is useful. I'm not going to control your arguments. Bring them up.
I think you're starting to realize that you were wrong and that your attack really uncharitable.
No, you're the one who's been attacking me uncharitably. All right, you make a hit video of me without talking to me about any of my positions? And
I'm supposed to hit you up before I make a video after you publicly attack someone for charity?
You're like roommates with one of my friends, right? Like,
That has nothing to do with anything, bro. That's fucking
private. It's not like we don't have any connections. Okay. We're total strangers.
Hey, can you go back, please, really quick and look at my social blade? I have a question. So the month of June 2019, where you're pulling these videos from, you can hold on.
Where did those 12 million views go?
I said there was one that was November 4th, 2019, which was after you said.
Can you please keep going through?
Turning Points event.
Can you please?
After you went to your Turning Points event, posted a video attacking trans people. So everything I said is actually true.
No, it wasn't.
You did
and
attack
you're,
trans
you,
people.
No, what you're
after
what you
out with
said.
Turning Points USA people. Did you or did you not?
You are so post hoc justifying a statement that you know is incorrect,
is right,
my dude.
Or is it wrong?
It's wrong.
Did you attack trans? So you didn't attack trans people.
I want you to open up my social blade. Okay.
Well, no, don't pivot.
This is not a pivot. We were just on the social blade. You're the one that just pivoted.
After going to a Turning Points USA event that you were invited to because you were alt-right, did you or did you not attack
trans
people?
That's a lie. Poisoning the well right there. One, I was not alt-right. In fact, I was never really considered alt-right. Even when
Hunter's right here, but he should have pushed back on it earlier because Mike has already called him alt-right like 6 times by now.
I was pretty far right and
you
did
were more just like, well, how would you describe it? Kind of like
I did. I definitely associated with people that were alt-right and I fucking...
Would you call Sargon of Akkad alt-right?
Yeah, that's why I was arguing with him that entire conference. Another detail you left out, by the way, in your video on me.
Whether or not you guys were getting demonetized by tech.
And I was telling him he wasn't and that it was a conservative victim mentality. I've literally still defend those statements. That was the beginning of my fallout with the right.
I agree with you with that.
Okay, great. So click my social blade now. I want you to look at something.
Did you link it to me?
Yeah, I put it down in the chat.
One of the most insidious things about the conservative online circuit back in those days, and if Shuwen's still in chat, she can attest to this as well, is that while there were alt-righters, the big problem was that there were a lot of people who weren't alt-righters who couldn't tell when other people were alt-righters. The big problem is that like there were a lot of people who were making like, oh yeah, you know, I'm a classical liberal. I just don't like SJWs, et cetera, et cetera. But then you look into their politics a little bit harder and they're like ethno-nationalists, you know? But it's hard to investigate that stuff if you're too close to them. You know what I mean? It can be really difficult, I think, to understand. It can be really difficult to understand the nature of that sort of thing, to recognize it. That's why the alt-right is so obsessed with dog whistles, because they don't want people to know what they are. It makes it way easier to pull over moderates, you know? Yeah, you look around one morning and you were like, wait, you're unironically racist. I thought it was a joke. Yeah. I've had that moment too. When I was in high school, for example, with like jokes about women, I've never really been sexist apart from like the kind of standard, oh no, cooties, you know, like you're 14 or 15 years old and like, oh yeah, women are dumb, whatever. Like not really a principled attitude towards sexism. I would make jokes about women, but I had a friend back then who was kind of a part of our friend circle, not like in the core, but sort of adjacent to it. And he would make jokes about women as well. And he was funny too. But the problem is one day, He got rejected, I think. I think it was rejected. I don't think it was dumped. I think it was rejected. And I was like, oh man, that sucks, dude. Cause like his feelings were hurt. And he started like really going off about women, you know, like, whatever, dude, just fucking whore anyway, stupid fucking bitch, doesn't care. And I thought, while listening to that, I was like, what? I was like, wait, hold on a second. This isn't funny. These aren't being framed as jokes. This seems like some actually negative feelings on this, you know? Yeah, and after that, I realized, like, the dude actually had issues, you know? And then we kind of stopped talking a little bit. That happens, and sometimes you need, like, that wake-up call. Like, you need evidence that a person is engaging in that kind of behavior unironically.
Okay, right, cool. Okay, sorry, I wasn't looking at that. Okay,
so click this, and you'll see, go down to monthly gained video views.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So first of all, you can see my sub growth.
Yes, I can see your sub growth.
You can see how great those grifter numbers are doing, all right? Okay. And then, yeah, Hunter, you can go over here. You can see in June of 2019, terminated.
So hold on. What month did you pivot from the right?
When I came out as being more of a centrist, it would have been March, I believe, which you can see right before then and before that also. In June of 2019, I deleted nearly 12 million channel views. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, that's more views than your entire Twitch channel has.
What rhetorical strategy can even be effective on someone as dishonest from Mike from PA? Mike from PA is so lacking in self-awareness that I feel like you come off looking good anytime you talk with him, you know? Like, that's the thing. I feel like Mike from PA is so incapable of holding his own that any conversation you have with him, if you're even, like, reasonably intelligent, you should look, like, fine, you know?
Then, if you go over here to the month of December 2019, you can see that I deleted another 3.5 million views. Then, if you go over here to the month of July 2020, you can see I terminated another 2.8 million views. So, you ask me to delete the videos. I have been doing that.
Like, I've not seen your debate with him. Was it like this, too? I got him so mad, dude. I got Mike so mad. He was, like, frothing after our conversation. He swore that he would try to sabotage any IRL political activities that I do in the future. Like he was like a cartoon villain when you defeat them and they're like, "You'll never work in this town again," like that. Like some anime rival shit where he goes blasting off again. It was a good debate, you know?
Like I said, it's a process. You can see here that it's been still moving in a process. And actually, I've been gearing up to purge another batch of these videos. But nonetheless, most of these videos are not monetized.
So you agree with me. You just want to do it the most advantageous way for your channel.
My dude, do you think if I was prioritizing my channel benefiting, do you think I would have ever...
Why are you answering the question? The question is yes because is the answer, right?
No, because... I mean,
okay,
no.
Then do
yeah,
it all
no.
now. But then it'll kill your channel, which means you're contradicting yourself.
Nothing is ever going to be good enough for people like Mike, okay? If Hunter deleted or privated all these videos right now, do you know what Mike would say? Mike would say, well, why didn't you do it earlier? Huh? Clearly, you were making grifty bucks. Like, there's absolutely no way to please somebody like him because all of this is performative bullshit virtue signaling theater that he's doing. It has no meaning or purpose. He's not trying to improve or determine anything. It's just performative denunciation for the sake of looking better than you. There is no way to win this, like, by appeasing him.
Either you're
so you want me to nuke my entire channel?
No, I think you should leave up all the positive videos that you have that you agree.
I would have to go back to those videos that you're pointing out to if they have any fundamental disagreement that I still have.
The hard work of saying that you're leaving the alt-right is to go back and review all the damage you've done.
Mike,
and saying,
I've done this.
I've done all this
Stop
damage.
It. You're gatekeeping again. Here's what you're saying.
I'm telling you what someone who is actually sorry
for what
they did would do. Like, come on, man.
Is it true that you used to be a former Republican?
Oh, no.
Dude, this was before I was any kind of public figure.
So what? Is it true that you used to be a registered Republican?
Absolutely.
People can change. Are you serious?
What? I believe in changing.
Interesting. Wait, you switched to being a Democrat just so you could run against the candidate that already BTFO'd your mom in the same race? Oof. That sounds really griftery, dude. Apparently, you raised over 50K? Shit.
First of all, I raised over 100K.
Holy fuck. This guy raised over 100K by just switching to being a Democrat. Sounds like something a grifter would
do. You know who I raised it from? You know who I raised it from?
Who?
That would be Planned Parenthood. That would be the AFL-CIO.
Holy shit. So you switched to the left and got a bunch of money and benefited from this and got some publicity?
Dumb motherfucker. That's the point. I actually did real work campaigning with real people, had the support of real people.
I experienced a real defeat. You don't understand. I lost for real.
Heard your speech and I don't really need it. What you're doing right now is...
I wasn't in Turning Points USA doing cancer shit. After Bernie Sanders had announced his second campaign, you were out there.
I've seen your
propaganda.
Clips, man. I've seen you spreading your bullshit about Bernie and, oh, he's going to win. And then you got really embarrassed when he didn't and everything else. But we don't need to talk about any of this right now because
Can I get that clip, by the way? That might be the funniest Mike from PA clip, even more than the Bad Bunny couch punch or the shoulder touch. The clip where Destiny says he thinks that Biden's going to win and Mike from PA has an aneurysm. Does anyone have that? I need that clip.
Were you even a supporter of Bernie Sanders?
When in the general, this last time? No, I voted for Biden.
So you were never a supporter of Bernie Sanders and you're
that's not true. No. I liked Bernie Sanders. I did, but
you liked Bernie Sanders. Yeah. Right. Okay. You liked him in hindsight. Now that your friends are Bernie Sanders supporters. Okay. You now,
my dude,
are
you're jumping all around right now. And what you're trying to do is preach to me and it's not going to work.
Yeah.
So
this
let's
gatekeeping is insane. It's like, who'd you vote for then? It's like, you know, didn't vote for Bernie. I'm not gatekeeping or anything. What did you eat for breakfast this morning?
What we were talking
preaching.
About, first
this
of all.
Is all just an example.
Somebody
like,
give me that clip.
So here's the thing about you.
Mike,
you
no, I don't want your psychoanalyzing right now. You need to let me respond.
At bad faith attacks on people's character.
That's what the you're doing right now, labeling me a former fascist. Give me a fucking break.
Former,
now what?
I mean, that, okay.
Yeah, that's what you former in quotes because you're implying that I'm still a fascist. Okay, I get.
I think you're more of an opportunist. I don't think that you're a fascist. I get what you just kind of.
Dude, I get like the idea of all the people in the universe. Okay, nobody is less of a grifter than Hunter. Man, is that Mike's gatekeep line? Because I liked Bernie in 2016 when I was a peak head ass. Shoo, I would love to see you talk with Mike. Okay, because I still think you have better political instincts than he does. And I, honest to God, I just want to see the cauldron bubble, okay?
I know what you think, Mike.
Oh, wait, sorry. Mike can't talk to girls. I'm sorry. Wait, never mind. Hold on. That'd be really, really mean to him. Hold on. No. That's...
But I really want to get back to what you're saying. So you're trying to basically gatekeep. Okay. You're saying it doesn't count.
It's not a gatekeep,
No,
man.
Yes, you are.
It's
you're saying
not
unless you
a gatekeep.
Your channel.
Oh, here it is. Here it is. Please, God. 18 seconds in.
I can win by being...
Gun pointed to your head. You have to pick one, Destiny. Who you think is going to win?
I think Biden.
Gun pointed to your head. You have to pick one, Destiny.
Who you think? What an idiot!
Fuck.
What an idiot!
And so today, I am announcing the suspension of my...
He's excited, okay?
...my campaign. Thank you all very much.
But it ends now, simp. I'm telling you, all the simpies that are watching this right now, break free. Start lifting immediately.
It? Punch
something.
Is that
something.
It? Is
I
that
say
all
punch,
the mic
you know
part?
What I mean. But
that,
I am also saying
okay.
that you should do
is
that.
Is that it? Is that the only part that I'm in?
Because it's boring me now. All right, cool. Fucking goddamn it, chat.
Me too, Mike. What was the first one?
I can win by being the alpha male.
So the guy pays for my tab.
I think they. I'm getting your attention. I'm getting your attention. I'm getting your attention.
I feel like I touched like.
Gun pointed to your head. You have to pick one, Destiny.
We have to stop. We have to stop. We have just.
of every single video all at once this very instant, then it's just because you want your channel to benefit.
We have another one. I'm sorry. He just makes a lot of good content.
Super sheltered life do you have that you never ran from the cops?
Now you get me copyrighted. No. Oh yeah, do you remember that? When I said like, hey, if the cops pull you over, you shouldn't run because you might get shot. And he was like, word up from the streets, dog. My name's Michael from PA. PA Street. And I'm here to tell you, run from the cops. I know what I'm talking about.
You're creating a straw man. Why are you creating a straw man?
Is that not what you just said?
I never said purge everything right this instant. Do it right now. Call me daddy. But what I said is,
did he not just say this?
Okay, do you believe...
Hey, chat, can we get a clip,
why
please?
Why do you...
No, because I'm going to hold you to your words because everything you tried to deny...
I gave you an example. I didn't stamp my feet and say, do it all right this moment. I asked you why you haven't done it because you agree that they're harmful, right? Your old videos are harmful videos, right?
My harmful old videos I've largely removed. There are still some up that I'm going to be removing.
So everything up right now, you would say you agree
with
right now.
No, not everything. You're doing it again.
Are they harmful or do you agree with them?
There are some content... There's still some content up that I agree would be harmful, that I don't agree with.
I think there's value, by the way, in leaving up like old videos sometimes. I think you can make an argument for like that, making very public like the growth of the channel or like archiving that stuff. And I don't know how much that circulates in the algorithm anyway. And probably still a lot. I don't know. I'd have to think about it. Does Mike from PA delete old videos or do his videos only go back a year and a half? Or does he delete old stuff? Wonder if I could find some old problematic stuff from him. Apparently, he used to be a Republican. I was never a Republican. I don't think he had a channel till last year. Oh, okay.
That I'm in the process of still removing, Mike. That's what I'm saying.
So there are harmful videos that people are watching, right? Like some right-wingers are still watching some of your videos.
I don't
know.
I mean, I've go look at how many subscribers I've lost. Like, I purged my audience from far right-wingers, and I'm now purging my audience of just, like, sometimes even regular right-wingers. Like, do you know how many people are calling me, like, a grifter, right-wing, or I'm sorry, left-wing soy boy shill or whatever?
Again, this is unwinnable because even if Hunter Avallone deleted all the videos originally, it would still be like, well, what about this one tweet of yours? Or back in 2020, you made this comment in a video, which was otherwise okay, but this comment was bad. Don't you think that's harmful? It's just, this is dumb.
Whatever, because now I think that like trans people deserve human rights and shit.
Everybody to the left of Attila the Hun is a soy boy to them. So.
I know, and anyone that's to the right of you, you call like a fascist. So
incorrect. You just created I am not Vaush talking about Bush here. Okay.
First of all, I would like to just get back to what we were.
I don't call everybody a fascist and delete the term. I think Sargon of Akkad is a fascist.
Did you call me a fascist?
Did I call you a fascist?
Yeah, you did. Wait, hold on, Mike. Yeah, you did. And by the way, Hunter Avallone's political and social opinions were pretty in line with the Bush administration's. So, might want to lean back on that one. You called him more than fascist. You called him alt-right, dog. Oh my god. Might want to reel that one back in. Oh boy.
We're gonna keep
know,
on doing it.
I did or not.
Dude, you're so
right.
Fucking disingenuous. No, you
if
didn't.
If I call it, it's not disingenuous. I literally don't recall.
That's right.
You
know what? You're right. Disingenuous is the wrong word. You're
did
a.
I, did I call you?
Yes. Here's the tweet. Quote, former fascist.
He didn't even say he was a former fascist. He was denying that he isn't currently a fascist. This tweet is from 2 days ago. He'll just lie about anything.
With values to the right of Antonin Scalia.
Okay.
This is, you put former in quotes. What do you think that means?
Former. Yeah. No. You're alt-right. No. Okay. Okay. That's good. Okay.
He knows he's wrong. He's like, oh, okay. Whatever. Just like immediately back off. Dude, literally, he can just absolute fucking clown town with this guy. You can hold him on anything and he'll like fucking river dance his way away from it.
But former in quotes, are you not trying to imply that what I'm doing there is
why did you delete that?
That I'm still
tweet,
a fascist.
By the way. Why did you delete the tweet about burning?
Pivot. Oh wait, I don't have an answer for that. Pivot. Time for the next point. Quick, move.
flags is as cringe.
I clarified because for the same reason that I think that burning the flag is kind of cringy is the same reason that I deleted the tweet because I think that the flag.
No, Hunter, don't give in. You have to hold him to this point. Why was former in quotations there?
Because I think that the messaging can sometimes come across in a way that harms the potential to grow your movement. And in this case, as a public figure, I have a responsibility to make sure that my messaging is interpreted properly.
So burning the flag, should that be illegal or is it just cringe?
Notice how you...
Never did he say it should be illegal. He just says cringe. Right here.
He's wielding the cringe baton like every other right-winger online. You seem very...
That's what you do, isn't it?
Hold on, wait. Stop.
Isn't that what you do? Isn't that what you do in most
Mike,
of your
videos? Mike, I'm like, making a broader point, and you're not going to just cut in here and gish-gal at me, okay?
I'm asking you. Isn't that what you do in most of your videos? What you do is you find someone as a target.
He's literally, you do pivot so much. Oh, God. Okay, I'm going to have to gear up. I have to remember how much you pivot. So you've made it very well known, okay, that you don't like the use of my word cringe. Do you think that saying something's cringy is the same as advocating for something to be illegal?
No, I didn't say that.
So why did you say that I share the position? Hold on. In your video, you said I share the position with Donald Trump and then played a clip of Donald Trump saying you should go to prison for burning the flag, something that I myself have criticized Donald Trump for.
So I was...
Wait, quickly. Price is Right music is playing. How is he going to pivot out of this one? So Mike has once again been caught in a lie. How is he going to move away from this one? Is he going to move to a new topic? Yeah, is he going to say that Hunter Avallone is trying to meet a low standard of like purity testing? What's it going to be? Answer the question internally and then find out if you're correct.
That first of all, that's not what I did. I explained.
Deny it entirely.
Since you're denying everything that you've done.
Go and watch the clip. Okay. I was showing the context of why the difference between burning the flag and pledging of allegiance. Pledge of allegiance is done to every 5-year-old in American schools.
It's also really weird because then you went on to like...
brainwashy. Why are you talking? It's disgusting and
tore down a set.
Children do the leftist organized allegiance. Everybody who's not an American looks at that and goes, that's fucking weird.
All right, hold on 1 second.
But it's a position. Donald Trump is out there and the Republican Party.
Oh my God.
A constitutional amendment to make it illegal to burn the flag.
I know that's really fucking bad. And I criticized it.
They have arrested people. They have assaulted people for burning the flag.
All right. I'm trying to watch the clip now.
Hey, it's me. Look. This was yesterday's stream. It live. Well, this happened.
Yeah, so can we hold on 1 second, please?
In a 5-4 decision, Antonin Scalia.
All right, hold on.
Sided with the liberals.
Mike, literally, what the fuck are you talking about, dude? Mike, he doesn't want to make it illegal. What are you doing? Shut up.
I know. I'm very glad about that. Legal. I've defended this multiple times. You're preaching to someone who already agrees with you, my friend.
Now you're out there saying burning the flag is cringe. Because of who you are.
No. Okay.
What does that have to do with
the
law?
Please, because you're just preaching to me, and I'm begging you to just shut up for a minute so I can watch the clip.
This is not trying
to make
arguments.
Leftist organizers.
Okay, this is when you have to mute Mike. By the way, when I mute people during debates, this is when I have to do it. Okay, because holy shit, Mike at this point is only talking to prevent Hunter Avallone from watching the clip that proves him wrong. I think he's actually deliberately doing that. Going on that long tirade about the legality of burning the flag and Antonin Scalia's 5-4 decision, like, okay? Like it has nothing to do with anything, but he knows that Hunter Avallone is about to watch a clip proving that he lied, like, for the 7th time.
Radical people right now, marginalized among the left.
While I show my fuck you. I'm gonna have to show my
First
chat.
Time
the,
you've ever heard them, have
no, I have to show my chat the clip here where you tried to compare my position to Donald Trump's. So, do you want to hold on just 1 second? It's at the 6-minute mark of your video.
With a capital, fuck you. And the other thing is, I gotta tell you that this is a position that's shared with Donald Trump.
Wait, are you playing?
This is a position that
literally word for word, literally fucking. Word for word, open quote, end quote, this position is shared by Donald Trump. Something Mike just said wasn't the case, and that he was actually just making a comparison of some other thing.
That's shared with Donald Trump or by Donald Trump. That's what you said. That's the quote.
How will he pivot from this?
Hold on 1 second. Let me watch the clip.
Okay.
Hold on 1 second. You've got such a delay on your stream, so it's really long.
I do have a delay on the stream, yeah. My internet sucks.
This is a position that's shared with Donald Trump.
I'm gonna have to literally write down
No, no, oh, no, that, so, first of all.
Is he about to admit he was wrong? No way. There's no way it's gonna be that.
Donald Trump doesn't think they're equally as cringy. Donald Trump thinks burning the flag is obviously should be illegal. So that's not a position shift. Now, the idea of.
So are you admitting then that that was a little bit of an unfair
what I would say
comparison?
Is,
because obviously say me saying something's is, cringy isn't the same.
What I would say is he would agree that burning the flag is bad.
That isn't what he was saying. You can't. If a person says, hey, you know, I don't like. You know, I don't like burning the flag. That's not the same position as people who burn the flag should be deported. That's not the same position. You can't say that, dude. You can't, like, if a person's like, yeah, I wouldn't date a trans person, that's not the same as a person saying, I want legal euthanization for all trans people. Even though the people who want legal euthanization for all trans people probably also wouldn't date a trans person, that does not mean they're the same position, okay? Holy shit. The flagrant dishonesty. I do not know how Mike has an audience. I genuinely don't know if they're bots and he just has a couple of Oilers like giving him subs. I genuinely don't know. But I know the ultimate victim of Mike is Mike, okay? Because Mike is such a desperately and pathetically insecure person. If you go into his chats during his live streams, his own chat is tearing him apart constantly. I don't know where the market is. I genuinely do not, okay?
Okay.
And you agree with Donald Trump that burning the flag is bad, right?
I mean, that's I think that, no, I...
No, but Donald Trump's position isn't that it's bad. It's that he wanted to deport people who did it. That wasn't his position.
A little bit of hyperbole.
Biden probably also thinks that, by the way. If you ask, like, hey, Biden, do you think it's good to burn the American flag? He would probably say something like, no, I don't, but I think First Amendment, blah, blah. Like, he probably also thinks it's bad. I imagine most every president ever elected believes that. Donald Trump is the one who wanted to deport people.
But go on.
Okay, so I can literally, I don't know how much of my stream you saw, but I wrote out like a little explanation. So maybe if you'd like me to read it to you. What I said is that leftist...
You change your...
Wait.
...position after you got a lot of pushback and
this is another lie. I'm so glad you brought this up. Okay, great. Now I get to make you eat your words again. This is great for me. Thanks.
You didn't make me eat shit. You didn't make me eat shit at
all. Right, hold on. We're going to go ahead over to this one now. We're going to go ahead to...
Mike doesn't eat shit at all. He just gets it smeared over his face. People hold the big spoon of poop up to his face and it just kind of rubs against his lips, but he won't open it. He won't take his lumps like a big boy.
Here's this video.
If I was Hunter, I would drop a tactical N-word right now. Yeah, it wouldn't be the first time, I'm sure.
What a desperate fucking redirect, dude. Being called out on lying like 20 times in a single debate. I've never seen a debate where somebody got caught on this many lies, by the way. Huh, I bet he's about to say the N-word. You're so weak, bro. Jesus.
Nope, that's not even true. Again, trying to poison the well.
You would defend the right to...
All right, hold on. Wait, stop, because you made a claim. That was wrong again.
Trying to pivot again, now trying to talk about the N-word.
All right, go to the... 3 minute 12 second mark here from a
Mike
video.
Mike is I hypocrite level. I actually disagree. I think that I hypocrite makes Mike from PA look like a fucking fool. I hope that Mike from PA never gets any real clout because he'll lose every debate he ever does with a conservative. Like any conservative who isn't like, I don't know, like critical thinking veteran tier is just going to get is going to annihilate him. Somebody like I Hypocrite is easily like I Hypocrite looks like a fucking brain genius compared to this guy. I'm not joking when I say that, by the way.
In June 22nd, 2020,
all right, hold on.
Where I say the same thing.
I see. Okay, I think we've gotten the vibes here, haven't we? We've gotten the vibes. I feel like we've gotten the vibes here.
We're led astray, and you're trying to figure out the world, and you're doing it publicly, and I give you credit for that. I actually don't want to cancel you. I don't want to chase you off the internet.
Really?
After an hour of gatekeeping and purity testing of, I bet you want to say the N-word now. Dude, I'm not trying to, like, purity test you. The funny... Yeah, okay. The funny thing is like, okay, one of the reasons that, like, for a long time I wasn't that hard up on Mike from PA is because I felt like a lot of his personality deficiencies were some kind of defense mechanism after the abuse that he suffered from, like, Bad Bunny. But he seems just as abusive. The gaslight gatekeep girl boss vibes from Mike from PA are just as extensive. So I don't know. I feel like their, like, relationship must have just been, like, an unstoppable force of movable object dynamic. Because, like, can you imagine, like, being friends with somebody like him? Like, can you imagine ever having, like, a friendly disagreement with him? Like everything must be insufferable, you know? I don't know. He could fix this. Mike, it's not too late. It's not too late, Mike. You can fix who you are, okay?
Right now. You don't like me. Well, people think it's going to play well with Vaush's audience. That's hopes for YouTube relevance again.
No.
Reach out to you and say, let's leave this all aside.
No.
I'm hurt that you would attack me. You're hurt that I would attack.
This is abuser shit. Like, unironically, lie about everything during the debate. At the end of it, say that he wasn't trying to be a moral Puritan, you know, that you were the one who actually initiated all of this. I feel hurt that you attack me. Fuck, dude.
Attack you now. You did attack me first. Oh, that's fine. I'm willing to leave that aside.
There it is.
And say, I think in your heart of hearts, you're a good guy.
Vaush, why do you insist on calling everyone you disagree with an abuser? If you don't recognize abusive tendencies in Mike from PA's behavior, then I don't know if you've ever been in an abusive relationship, because this is some one-to-one shit, okay? This isn't like a red flag. This is a promenade painted red, okay? This is very clearly, it's not just the lying, it's the weaselly attempts at manipulating the emotional state of the person that you're arguing with. Lying, then lying about the lies, then lying about the lying about the lying about the lies in order to gaslight them, to make them doubt their self-perception. Like, this is fairly straightforward abusive behavior. It's not being done to a partner here. I mean, maybe he does it to people in his life otherwise, but...
Well, thanks.
And you were led astray. I think in your heart of hearts, you're a good guy.
Like this.
You were led astray. And you're trying to figure out the world, and you're doing it publicly, and I give you credit for that. I actually don't want to cancel you. I don't want to chase you off the internet.
Really?
I don't
want to call you a racist? Professional grifter and call me a former, quote, fascist
and
then imply
N-word
heavily
sayer,
that I was criticizing
whatever.
Trans people at my Penn State speech.
Okay. You didn't criticize people at the Penn State
speech. You're doing
it
again. You're doing the thing where you
but
suck
you
up
did.
To the person.
I'm not sucking up to you. What
you
I'm
are.
Doing
you're
to you.
You're sucking up to me
I'm
right
telling,
now. I don't like
I'm
it.
I'm trying to, this is called a rapprochement, where I'm trying to tell you that you can divert course from what's going on right now. I'm willing to help you change and say that you are not a bad guy. But if you're going to go out there and just
and
throw out attacks against people...
I can help you, Hunter. I can show you the way. But you have to listen to me. And you can't attack me like you've been doing, okay? I'm trying to help you.
You can't be
surgery.
Surprised when they're like, why is this guy?
I didn't even make an attack against
people yes,
with
you
my
absolutely
tweet.
Did. You absolutely did make attacks against me and people who burn
these
the flag, which is associated with left-wing
right,
activists.
On. I'm going to try to pull up
by the way,
this. Hold on.
This little...
And
dude,
you're so
to convince
concerned with narcissistic
is that
injury right now.
With...
I'm not concerned
you're
with anything.
You're worried that I am bad, that I'm making you, that I'm saying that you're a fascist, that I'm lying about this, and you're nitpicking one thing when you know you were still alt-right at this point, when you were going no. to turn...
Didn't he earlier rebuke the alt-right claim?
Point. You
wrong.
disagreed with the thing about the unfair censorship.
My dude, I
always
with
gave
Vaush
you that point.
At the end of the year, at the end of, I think it was the beginning of 2020, where I explicitly said how like I was really uncomfortable with how many like alt-righters seem to be in my audience, and I was purging my audience of that. That was the beginning of that. For you to claim that I was alt-right when I was
still
going
still
to the TV
making,
USA events
but you were
is
still
delusional.
Making the same content
no.
for six more months.
Does anyone else think it's funny that Mike from PA would accuse me of overusing the term fascist when he's calling Hunter Avallone alt-right for making like clickbait videos about how feminists are cringe? And like child drag queens are bad. Does anyone else feel like that might be a significantly like greater reach, definition wise?
It's maybe bullshit, you talked about, my dude. Maybe you start to have internal conflict.
He started
conflict.
When he was literally a teenager.
And I understand that.
He
maybe
started
that internal
making
conflict,
his videos
public...
literally as a content
the reason,
was
so,
the same shit, the, right? Like, come on.
The
Wasn't your public
that,
content mostly the same stuff?
The reason that I'm so intense
Just
on...
answer the question. Oh Don't ignore God. The question.
I
was
am going to ignore
it
because I wasn't really listening because I was still grazing through this clip because everything that you've said about me, when I ask you if you've said it, you deny it. And then I have to go find the clip to prove that you actually did say it. So the reason that I'm so obsessed, I guess, if you will, with finding out that, you know, you're lying to me and my audience here when you say you didn't say these things is that I think it shows what kind of little research you put into your videos. You know, if you jump up on your high horse and LARP in front of your dipshit audience, that you can get a
There's
bunch
no
of cheap
LARPing.
Brownie points. Yeah, you
this
know
not,
that you can get a bunch of cheap brownie points when if you had so
I've
much
said
as typed.
Substantive.
If
everything
you,
I've been, everything I've
I know,
said is substantive.
I know that's what you
I
think,
talked
dude.
About movement,
but if you had
I
so much
about
as
the But letter from the Birmingham jail, all you've done is insulted me.
Letter from a he had to scramble for that one, huh? Dude, I talk about shit with substance. I talk about movements. I talk about letter from a Birmingham jail. Yeah, I talk about real shit. Is that? Yeah? During the live stream, he tried to call Hunter a white moderate. Little did Mike know about the lesser known Lettle from a Cuckingham jail written by MLK, where he complains about the only thing worse than a white moderate, which is a white cringe lord. Okay. And he just drew Mike from PA. He just did a drawing of Mike. Mike wasn't even born yet. It was prophetic.
You just okay. insulted me the whole time.
If you, had
you
so
just
much
said, I'm never
searched...
going to listen to somebody like you. You're cringe. What's the tip?
I didn't even
that
call
was
you
what
cringe,
you
I
that
think.
Is actually
and
that
I still
want to
know what
you...
a tip is, but if you had gone and actually searched my name, Hunter Avallone, you would see the
okay.
first article that comes up.
I want to teach you what a tiff is because
oh,
it's
no.
about politics, which
I already know what
it is.
I looked it up after the thing, okay? And I looked up sewer socialism too. So shout out to that one.
I'm still not looking up tiff. I will never know what a tiff is. It's too funny for me to not know. I will never learn. If I ever get into like a debate on the granular elements of tax policy in a city, I will lose that debate specifically because I refuse to learn what a TIF is.
That's good. I'm glad. And
yeah.
do you understand why that was relevant to why you wouldn't vote for a neoliberal candidate in
no,
a primary?
I
wasn't a neoliberal.
Choose what would actually get something done or move closer to our goal than what you do, which is
fifth,
LARPy bullshit.
The guy who
so,
finished
again,
fifth out of fifth. By the way,
if
I've
you had
elected
so much
more people
has...
to people to a local and.
Hey guys, remember when Mike from PA's solution to Omaha's debt problem was to annex suburbs in like the regions adjacent, except there were no more suburbs to annex because he didn't know anything about the city. And then we did some research and it turns out that suburbs cost disproportionately more than urban areas, meaning that would actually increase the tax drain significantly. Remember all that? Remember how not only did Mike propose a bad solution, he proposed the optimally worst one. Like, he proposed just adding debt to the city. That was the solution.
Federal offices and statewide offices than Vaush.
Okay, so if
so,
you had so,
so
much
I've
as
actually,
type
why
my
does he keep
replay,
mentioning
me?
Me
a LARPer. You're a fucking Turning Points guy. I've actually
Am
got
I with
people
TPUSA?
Elected to offices.
Hold on.
Oh, yeah, dude. This is such a good meme. Why does this only have 550 upvotes, dude? Here's Mike's plan to fix the city deficit for Omaha, Nebraska, okay? You see, we launch the city troopers west to begin with, okay? And then we annex one half of the farmland. God, as if you could just annex all territory around you. Oh. God. We have to have another conversation with Mike sometime in the future, dude. It's too good. Every time he and I come into contact, it's good.
Hold on, wait. So I'd like to actually address
that. I'm sorry. You were just one of their content creators that
no,
the right-wing billionaires
this
highlighted.
Was... Okay.
And the Pennsylvania, Penn State...
this is a lie.
Turning Point chapter brought you in because they thought of you as a right-winger. That is what... So,
so
you agreed
this was
with
the
me.
TP... Hold on. This
what
was...
does this own? Huh, they only invited you to the TPUSA event because they thought you were right wing. Yeah? Yeah?
Oh, they didn't know. They thought you were just going to do the same right wing
so
shit.
So this was a
friend,
TP. Hold on.
Carl
this was a TPUSA like chapter. Okay. So I was not affiliated with Turning Point USA in the sense that I was like, I was not being paid by
were
them.
You paid? Were you paid for the speech?
No, I was not.
Okay, so they just
I don't know.
He came over.
What is he asking right now? Were you paid? Was Carl paid? What? Who's
from the UK? So they probably paid for his flight stuff, right?
I don't know, but I do know this: that at one point I was paid from another place, PragerU, to make a video that was incorrect information about gender. So you know what I did is, one, I took down that video, and two, I donated that money
to
a pro.
Is it down from? Is it still on PragerU? Can I go find it? Like, can we watch it?
I don't think so. No, because I was paid according to the views it got from my Instagram. So I took the money that
It wasn't a PragerU video, but you were paid by PragerU.
I was paid by PragerU, and it was like a shout out for PragerU and shit.
Is there like a big network of this is something that you actually might be.
Mike literally doesn't care about any of this. He just likes running down the clock in the conversation.
Useful for you to do is like exposing this stuff. Like,
well, so I'm trying to explain how when I did actually profit, I then donated that money. So I donated that money to a pro LGBT cause, right? Because I realized that it would be wrong for me to try and make
money. Which one?
Yeah, like, look at this. He doesn't give a fuck. He's just going to keep going. Why, where, why, how, what, why, until we like run down to the fucking subatomic particles of the universe. Oh, I chose this charity. Yeah, do you have any emails from that charity, like, proving it? Yeah, I can look for one. Yeah, like, I'd like to see that. Can I get, like, an email confirming you donated to a charity? Like...
Did you, like, post a receipt or anything on...
Yeah.
God damn it!
Yeah, I did.
I
put it in the name... of another guy who was calling me out for it. So yeah, I can try to find the receipt, my email, if you want.
I mean, listen, I believe you. I'm not trying to say that you're lying here.
I'm seeing beyond the veil of time and space.
This hostility when you were the aggressor in this relationship, so to speak.
I called you out for what I thought was
I never once attacked Vaush. I never said his name. I never said his fundraiser was bad. Gotcha. I was specifically
just
talking
like you never called me
you,
a former nationalist.
By the way,
just like you never
way.
Said that I was.
I never mentioned Vaush when I talked about the charity fundraising being done on a prominent live stream raising $250,000 for the PCRF. I didn't say Vaush.
But you and a bunch of other Vaush hangers on tried to.
Where's the clip on Mike from PA? Where's the clip on Mike from PA on the PCRF? It was like 4 minutes long. Where is it?
Aid is something that's very different. That they're low. Most of the and three.
Come on.
The. And
sign except give money to charity.
Machine
emails from people. Mike from PA called you a liberal for donating to charity. Oh, that's delightful. Hold on. I just need to hear this. Was 26 hours into the live stream, by the way. We're gonna do this again in the future, by the way, because this was super fun. Can you believe I'm 40 pounds lighter now than I was then?
Executive director, the finance director, the fundraising machinery. And so as a leftist,
oh no. He's gonna
do it. I find most charities to be highly problematic and don't like the liberal mentality of philanthropy. That's just not
There is a grain of truth to this. Give me the rest. It is not relying on charity. Give it meaning. Now that we're past the
charity streams and things like that.
Oh, this is 4 minutes.
Is they're self-promotion vehicles primarily.
We can listen to this while we play.
And I don't like that. A real charity stream would be either somebody who doesn't stream often streaming just for the purpose of doing the charity stream, or streaming on someone else's channel, hopefully, in order to support that organization. You know, that would be a true charity stream. But a lot of these charity streams are self-aggrandizing fests where you get a bunch of people to raid into you out of solidarity for the charity. You promote yourself. You virtue signal as if you are a good person. And a lot of the money that goes to charities goes toward the executive director, the finance director, the fundraising machinery.
Now we're getting the
and
the
so
little bit.
As a leftist,
yeah, okay, now we get the little.
I find most charities to be highly problematic and don't like the liberal mentality of philanthropy. That's just not something that I like to do myself, because I feel like it's disgusting, like it is profiting off of other people's misery.
Profiting?
And it's bad.
Personally, I find it immoral when you raised $250,000.
I'm not saying nobody should do charity streams or that charity streams are 100% toxic or anything like that. It's just when you come to this channel, this is not a liberal channel, okay? I need you to understand that, because I'm going to challenge a lot of your liberal assumptions.
Oh my God.
And I need you to know that. And charity is liberal. Charity puts the charity giver in a position of power over the person receiving the charity. Charity is not something that's revolutionary. Charity is something that supports the status quo. It doesn't mean that all charity is bad or we should never have mutual aid. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that most of the time,
then what is he saying?
I am not interested in that as an axis of action. Charity is liberal, meaning charity equals bad. No. American charities have collapsed the entire markets by flooding one product. Haiti, as an example, was flooded with rice to the point that their local agriculture collapsed.
Let me jump in.
And I know that
mutual aid
is something that's very different from charity, because mutual aid is about building a power structure. Okay?
Funnily enough, that actually isn't true. In line with the original definition of mutual aid, it absolutely includes charity. The original definition for mutual aid was incredibly broad. What was it, Bakunin? I learned this while reading up and listening to some stuff from Anarcho-Pack. Now, what is her name? I keep calling her Anarcho-Pack, but that's not the name she goes by anymore. It's not for a long time. Zoe Baker, thank you, yeah. She was talking about the original meaning of that kind of stuff, and yeah.
Building a power structure among equals.
Among
us. At the moment, I do think these widespread charity drives for Palestine are helping change the narrative, helping to widen the Overton window. I think that's true for sure. I think that's true for sure. So you know, which is why I participated in them, donated, and supported, for example, Chapo's. Like, Chapo's charity stream was good because the Chapo boys don't stream on the Chapo Twitch stream. Like, that's not, it's not their brand, really. They make their podcast. Their friends play Fortnite on the Chapo stream. You know, that's not what it's for. It's for, you know, they came on there for that. It's not
opening up his pockets,
sort of
scrambling, finding any excuse. They play Fortnite there. That's not their main channel.
Charity streams and things like that is their self-promotion vehicles primarily.
I think it's and now. So anyway, the reason why we watched all of that is because Mike from PA just said that he never technically mentioned my name in that little rant that we just listened to while I was playing Super Mario 64. And while it's true that he never mentioned me by name, there were only a couple giant charity live streams going on at the time, and he was condemning them broadly, but then something said something positive about the other one that was going on. So yeah, I Yeah, I don't know, you know? Now, I didn't say Vaush. It was just in the middle of this massive charity stream, which, hey, by the way, how cool was it that we got nearly 300K in that charity stream? And we had 24-hour lead up to that announcement. We literally just had a day's announcement. I just decided that we were going to do it, and I DM'd like a million people, and then it just happened. Next time, we're gonna have a lot more people. A lot more lineup, a lot more run-up time, you know? Do you have the receipts? Yeah, I have them like screen capped to my desktop, but I think they have like my info on it. Look, if I put it this way, okay, I had the guy who I ended up donating to on the stream. Unless I'm blackmailing him, I feel like he probably would have, you know, publicly announced. There probably would have been some sort of public indication that I had stolen $300,000 if that's the case. Show us your feed of no receipt. Wait, can I? Hold on. Maybe I just. Hold on. Do I have it? Let me see. Are they. Did I put them in the folder or in the recycling bin? Hold on. There you go. Well, I have to. Clearly photoshopped? Yeah, okay. How the fuck do you even transfer that much? That's why it took so long to transfer the money. My bank was like, oh, $300,000? You've never transferred even a 100th of that before, buddy. Hey, looks kind of suspicious to me. Yeah, my bank was kind of uncooperative. We're almost done.
Associate what I was saying as if it was some big attack on Vaush. When I was specifically talking about something that I find creepy and other content creators have called out, which is charity
streamers. This is so far removed
streamers.
From the conversation that I just don't care.
But this is the context. You launched attacks that were bad faith lies about me, including doing a cringe compilation where you lied about my relationship with somebody else.
I didn't make that cringe compilation. That was someone else's cringe compilation.
But you played it.
You put it at the beginning.
Hey, you made this video about me. No, I didn't. Oh, you watched it on your stream. Oh my God.
Why did you do it? To poison the well, right?
Because I thought it was funny when you went up and you were like,
wait. You thought it was cringy too
because you cringed at it yourself. When you came up to Bad Bunny and you were like,
because we were hanging out.
I was just
out,
trying to get your attention. It was funny.
Because, and here's the thing that's funny about this. What, like, you are mischaracterizing shit. You put it up there to poison the well because you do the cringe
Says
stuff.
The guy that called me
you
a former fascist.
You are.
In
you by your own
you
admission.
You called me
former
in quotes,
alt-right.
Dude.
Are you alt-right or not? Were you alt-right or not?
I don't know what to do anymore because I
want
to end this conversation, but I know if I do, you're going
to
accuse me of rage quitting out or something. But
I'm trying to have you do one substantive point. One. But it's all about your narcissistic injury, whether you feel like I called you a former fascist, but you admitted you were alt-right.
Of course, you changed. I've admitted that. Of course I have. Duh.
And then
that's
you
like
said,
half
well,
my
Mike, I didn't.
I don't think Hunter was ever alt-right. We keep going back and forth on this.
Attack trans people at that event, but I did attract trans people the next week.
No, I never conceded
justified.
That I attacked trans people. That's a lie, too. You said two different times that I
what
attacked trans people.
What is this video? I just pulled it up.
Oh my God.
I'm gonna
what
go
is
find
this video
this
attack teenager Wait, brain?
What about
this
go
video?
Find
I just,
where
you,
made you
may think that a
it's not about the
did
video,
you or
Mike.
Did you
I think
not
it, no,
make
no,
a
no.
video attacking trans people after
this is called,
hanging out with Turning Point?
One,
USA?
No. Two, this is called post hoc justifying because you made the claim both on Twitter and in your video that I attacked trans people at the event. When had you done research, you wouldn't be in this tough situation now.
This isn't actually post-hoc justifying. Post-hoc justifying is when you make a claim and then try to find evidence for it afterwards. What Mike from PA is doing is lying, or arguably a Mott and Bailey, where the Mott, the position he can't defend, is that you attacked trans people at the TPUSA event, and the Bailey is the position he's retreating to, which is that you were negative towards trans people at some point vaguely during that time.
Now, where you're stuck trying to post-talk justify, looking really Weasley and bad faith to everyone watching.
You see, here's
and
the thing,
you
you're
just
doing
said,
ad hominems because this is a joke. Because you know I'm right. You did attack trans people after your Turning Point shit.
That's,
you
if
were
you
still,
had said he spoke at Turning TPUSA, then attacked trans people.
Videos 11 months ago. You
that's not true. 11 months ago,
videos.
I was debunking those right-wing videos, so that's another
you
lie.
Literally
I can't
have,
even have
can,
a conversation
on,
with a guy that's so fucking disingenuous at this point.
Dude, you're calling disingenuous because you know it's a fact.
No, I'm calling you, it disingenuous because you won.
Shit right here. I'm looking
because,
at it.
Hold on. Because feminist this entire comedy. Time, one, you're trying to find some saying, kind of a what, flaw Hunter, so that you can gatekeep you said, and purity you check. Said, two, you said you're claiming that
dude,
I...
You played the clip. You play it again. You said feminist comedy is like gay Muslim rights. They don't go together.
You I said it's like said Islam that. And gay rights. That. And then did you see what I said to respond to that clip?
That's from 11 months ago.
Yeah.
You said
and
I
recognize
you.
That
your audience, but that was 11 months ago.
No.
That's within
Stop.
A year.
Stop. We were talking about
that's right wing propaganda. That's we were... fucking vile shit, dude. Don't you agree?
Mike, save the posturing for later, okay?
You're wait, not going to get vile or not? Wait. Is that
I agree
vile
that
or
that
not?
Joke was bad. Yeah, I wouldn't make
what,
that joke
what was the
now.
Punchline? What's the joke? Can you explain the joke?
Yeah, the joke. The joke. Sure. The joke.
Wait, Hunter, you're taking the bait, Hunter. He doesn't believe in anything he's saying right now. He's scrambled for like 40 different things to attack you on. He's lied about half of them. He doesn't care about any of it.
Is that generally speaking, in Muslim countries, gay people aren't usually treated very well. Now, in hindsight, would I have made that joke? No. Would I make a joke like that today?
You didn't say
no.
Muslim countries. You said Islam.
I know. Would I make that joke like
you
today?
Didn't say Islam. You didn't say Muslim countries. So you're lying.
So
about
now
what
it's
joke-
really
now Mike for PA has an eye for the details. Okay. So he lied about like 67 things, but now you're lying, Hunter. You said Islam, not Muslim countries. Finally, debunked.
Really important what every intricate word is. Oh my God. I'm explaining what it is. Islam and gay rights. The reason I was getting at that is because.
I can't listen to Mike, dude. He's unironically so triggering. He lacks so much self-awareness. It's unbelievable to me. Holy fuck. I feel like he could be typecasted as like the most obnoxious piece of shit in any movie, and he wouldn't have to change his behavior at all. He acts like a stereotype.
So do you recognize that I can explain the joke, but at the same time recognize now that, yeah, that wasn't a good joke to make? And
when
I
say that you were within
see,
a year
you're not
doing
letting
right-wing
me respond.
Shit.
You're not even making...
No. Yeah, I
that wasn't a
right-wing
video,
now,
first of all. I would have to... The video
it's
where
not,
I was...
Wait, doing a cringe compilation of feminists is not a right-wing video?
I'm
in what
pretty
world
sure
are
in that
you
video
living
where I talked
in?
About the
so this is the reason why I adopted the rhetorical strategy that I did while talking with Mike. My rhetorical strategy was make him mad, fuck everything else. Because he doesn't believe a single fucking thing that he says, and he will drag out the conversation and jump between a trillion points, and he literally never admits when he's wrong, even when he's proven wrong. So what's the point? There's absolutely no point in engaging with him on those levels, you know? But the best part is that he's very emotionally unstable. So really the best thing you can do is just upset him. That's not like Weasley or anything. He literally cannot admit when he's wrong. So why? There's no standard for good engagement here. If you're talking with a person who is not willing to engage in good faith, then, I mean, honestly, just trying to make them angry with the truth is actually quite a bit better faith than them trying to own you with lies, you know?
Difference of pop feminism and genuine feminism, but again, I'd have to go back and look at.
And what world are you living in? Wait, what do you think feminism is?
Why are you?
And he doesn't. And he just asks a million questions. Remember, what is sewer socialism? What's a TIFF? Remember, the reason why we meme about those is because when he doesn't have arguments, he asks questions to waste time, to hinge the validity of all of your knowledge on like a bunch of random questions that have nothing to do with the actual discussion. He's done this like over and over during this conversation. He just runs down the clock.
Able to let me actually talk. You keep saying I haven't made a point, but every time I try to talk, you don't let me talk. So that joke that I made was wrong. And I think that it's bad because it leads to negative outcomes. I think that Muslims are already a marginalized group, and jokes like that literally do play into harmful narratives. So in hindsight, would I make a joke like that? No. Do I think that joke was wrong? Yes. Is it also factually incorrect, considering that most Muslims in America, at least, tend to be more progressive? Also, yes. So there you go. Changing your mind, and like you just said, apparently you have a lot of respect for me because I've changed my mind publicly or whatever.
Well, I don't have a lot of respect.
Going through the process
you,
of changing your
respect.
Okay, gotcha. Going through
the
process of changing your positions and your opinions, sometimes it's going to look like that. A process. Sometimes there are going to be certain jokes or voices I make
time.
That I don't agree with at this point.
That's not true.
Vice versa. It just seems really disingenuous of you, someone who has already claimed to destiny that you're not for cancel culture, to try and dig up these old things from my past to try
culture.
And hold me to them and then be like,
I'm
look, you haven't changed.
Culture.
You're still a former fascist or whatever.
I'm not for cancel culture. But when I see you tweet
Oh, I need clips from Destiny debate 2 years ago so I can try to refute him saying this about me after I launched an attack on people who really burn the flag.
That's not cancel culture, though. That's just trying to find hypocrisy in your opponent's argument. That's not what cancel culture is. Hunter Avallone wasn't digging up stuff to try to cancel Mike. He was digging up stuff because he thought Mike was being hypocritical, which he was. So,
that's all. It just seems like you agree with my position ultimately on like the optics and everything else.
I don't
like,
agree with your position.
All right, well, I know because you don't. Because you're are you live right now on your channel?
No, because I don't need your shit 5 years.
Oh, okay. Okay. What is that? I just thought for if anything, it would make sense considering like you know you kind of want to virtue signal for your audience, but.
I don't need the virtue. So, this is, by the way, your right wing talking points. Here you are again. Virtue signaling.
You've been posturing this entire time. You try to hold me to like every single word I've said. You've denied.
Remember when he accused people of doing charities of virtue signaling? Is that a right wing accusation? Is it right wing when he does it or?
Saying things that we have tweets of you saying, like, come on, dude, this is a joke, all right?
No.
At the end of the day, I think that we have some unreconcilable differences.
What are those unreconcilable differences? What are those unreconcilable?
Yeah, keep the convo going. Don't end the convo.
And you're someone that never delivers any positive criticism.
You're a liar.
Everything you've said has been false. If it comes out of your mouth, I think it just becomes false, literally. It's like, it's this bizarre thing. You're like a lying machine.
That's everything you need to know about Hunter Avallone.
All right, Mike, I will see you later. You have a good rest of your day. I'm going to hang out now, okay?
Cowardly little bitch.
No, I don't.
Ooh, that did not hit. Yeah. Is this middle school? Yeah, you're going to leave because you're a cowardly little bitch. Oh man, the tonal delivery there, like the mannerism is just.
Who hides?
I want to hear him insult me.
Who hides? Who hides? When
I'm hiding?
I said you went to a Turning Points USA and you were attacking trans people, and you went to Turning Points USA, you attacked trans people within the week.
As a teenager.
That's why Hunter Avallone did so well, because he was...
All right, he's muted. I'm gonna go find this clip, and then I'm not gonna unmute him until I find it, because I'm sick and tired of him making these lies up. Hold on.
Damn.
True.
Making his videos literally as a teenager. That's why Hunter Avallone did so well, because he was in the teenager binge. And... Or a ball... American flag is not the most effective means to cringe in the teenager brains. He was literally a teenager. Great suburban. And the other thing is, I gotta tell
you.
Bring
it up over here again, maybe?
Who you the fuck you are. In an area where, why don't you go back to Penn State and talk about the truth about transgenders?
Okay, right there. Perfect. All right, so Mike, I've unmuted you now. Right here at the 11 minutes, you say, why don't you go back to Penn State and talk about the truth about transgenders? Again, implying that my speech at Penn State was on some attack on trans people, which is just
so
untrue.
So you're saying it's
because it shows what little
it's implied, but you did do it, Hunter. You did.
It shows what little research
you
do. It shows what little research you do before you actually like even talk about these segments.
The research is right. You published a video claiming that the left is pushing for irreversible transitions among trans people as children. It's still up on your channel.
We already went over
a
this.
A week after. So
it doesn't
true?
Matter.
But this is
even
true.
If that video, hold on.
That's
you realize that even if that video was actually anti-trans,
point,
then
Hunter,
your statement
the
would
point
still
is
be
that
incorrect.
You attack trans people. Ed, we're hanging out with Turning Point USA. And now you're out there telling people that they're cringe if they burn the flag. That's your MO is the same shit you used to do when you were attacking trans people and videos you still profit from. Up right
nope.
Now, Mister. I'm a sock dem.
We
well, I'm not a
that.
Sock dem. I'm a liberal. What's your positions again?
I'm sorry, Mike.
What are your
I don't think we're
again?
Gonna have this.
I like how Mike tries to make his bad memory other people's problem.
Dude,
what are your positions anyway? Even this conversation's been going on for more than 1 hour, and I wasn't paying attention to any of it. And this is your fault, not mine.
Conversation anymore, considering that you
I
are now
think
denying
the end of the day is
in
when,
two
when
different
you
clips.
Get a, when you get a politics, when you get a politics, when you can actually articulate your views.
Alpha Mike, hit me up with the
why
lesson.
Why don't you articulate your views? What are they again?
Hit me up with the lesson.
Say,
Alpha Mike.
You don't
Alpha Mike.
Know
hit me up.
What your Oof. Own views are. Okay. Hey, Hunter, what are your views? What are your views, Hunter? What
I don't
are
know,
your
but
views,
they're definitely
Hunter?
Higher than yours, bitch. All right. Oh, my God. Oh, my
God. That was good.
That was a headache. Watch the video with him. We just did. It's
it doesn't mean it doesn't matter. It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything. Mike from PA, it doesn't mean anything. Any conversation with him should just be used to extract memes because there was no opportunity for conversation there. There's nothing else. It's empty. It's all empty.
This is it's not gonna.
How you doing, man? Uncritical support for Hunter Avallone. Okay, this turned into a segment, I guess. I don't know. Mike from PA Memes are so good. Enjoy, everyone. I love you. Drink your water. Stay hydrated.